Church joined forces to take on the teams of Breezango and Legado del Fantasma this Saturday on the TakeOver 30 pre-show.
Been the talk of social media, the situation between former NXT champion Adam Cole and former All-Pro NFL punter Pat McAfee. They come face to face now.
We welcome the Undisputed Era.
And you see Adam Cole, who called out Pat McAfee to show back up here to NXT last week. Adam Cole, an Undisputed Era, walking with a purpose.
You're gonna come out, let's go. Run your sin down. Talk a big game, let's go. Where you at? Let's go, Pat McAfee. Let's get this thing started.
Let's go, Connor.
Go, McAfee.
Let's go.
Undisputed Era. Last week, Adam, you said, please, please come see me face to face. Come back to the arena that I was kicked out of. I'm here. And I brought 28 years of NFL experience with me because I knew you better than you know yourself. I know that you go nowhere without these three stooges. I know that you would be nothing without these three stooges. And I know that you could never handle a face-to-face with a human like moi all by yourself.
Yeah, go ahead.
Yeah, you ready to start now? You ready to start now, Pat?
Do you remember what happened 2 weeks ago when you and I were in this same NXT arena, Adam Cole? You probably don't. This is how it ended. I'll remind you. Shawn Michaels was checking for vitals on your soulless body right over yonder next to stupid Tom Phillips. Last week, you go on this entire rant about how you were being held back, that I took advantage of a situation, blah, blah, blah. I outsmarted you in your own house. In your own business, I outsmarted you. Then you went on an entire, you suck. Then you went on an entire rant about how I'm not special. Not special. You're the longest reigning NXT champ. You've wrestled all around this globe. You've wrestled in front of 5 people at armories, bingo halls, high schools, Japan, all over the world. And you got to hear and you were the biggest star in this brand. What'd you call yourself? The king of NXT? You had all these people fooled. 400 and some days you were undefeated. Took me a minute and a half to knock your ass out. 1 minute. Knock your ass out. One swing of this foot. Done. Then you call me not special. How's that not special? I've never been in this ring before. Made you look amateur. I've made $1 million in 7 different professions. And you, especially you, stupid you, mustache stooge, in the ignorant wrestling community at home, you better hope that I don't stick with this profession, because this will be number 8 if I want to. And on Saturday, It's going to end the same exact way that it ended 2 weeks ago. You're going to be left unconscious after probably throwing a temper tantrum, after losing your mind, after losing your cool, because you and I are different level humans. You only gave me 2 weeks to train for this match. 2 weeks! Triple H gets on ESPN, the cerebral assassin who kicked me out, who says, well, if Pat wants to be tough, I can make him famous. 2 weeks is all I'm going to need to beat you. And you're going to have to explain to the entire wrestling community how you lost to an outsider. Let me tell you how you lost to an outsider. Because you're great. In this world, you are. But I am next level. I am above you as a human. I am above you as an athlete. And on Saturday, it's going to end with one swing of his foot meeting your face, sending it to the moon. And the only sound that any of these idiots in here and anybody at home will hear is
This Saturday at TakeOver, I'm gonna make you my bitch.
Saturday on the WWE Network.